Hello, dear students. Now today we will start our social studies class, and we already completed the chapter 9, India, Location and Extent. I hope you all read the chapter, and as I discussed in through our previous classes, the chapter is quite clear to you, I think. Now today I'll discuss on the question objective type question answers of this chapter. Okay, so first of all we should tell you the main points of the chapter. So the main points of the chapter are: the mainland of India extends between the latitudes 8 degree 4 minute north and 37 degree 6 minute north, and longitudes 68 degree 7 minute east and 97 degree 25 minute east. The Tropic of Cancer almost divides the country in two parts, Northern India and the Deccan and Peninsular India. And India is officially known as the Republic of India. It consists of 29 states, always remember, or India consists of 29 states and 7 union territories. There are 29 states and 7 union territories. India is broadly divided into 6 physiographical divisions. How many physiographical divisions are there? Yes. There are 6 physiographical divisions in our India: the Great Himalayas, the Northern Plains, the Desert Region, the Southern Plateau, the Coastal Plains and the Island Region. I'm telling you once again that whenever you read this chapter, you please consult the map. You have, I think you all have atlas. So, open the atlas and physical map of India, and consult with the map, and then read the chapter. Then it will be easier for you to memorize the chapter, and the chapter will be clear to you whenever you consult with the map. Okay, it is very much important. Next point is: the Great Himalayas consists of 3 parallel ranges, the Himadri, Himachal and Shivaliks. The Northern Plains are fed by 3 main rivers, the Indus, the Ganga and the Brahmaputra. Whenever you have a look on map and you can find these rivers and the Himalayas or the mountains, then the facts will be clear to you. Otherwise, only words or sentences in the books, you can't memorize with that. So, maps are very much necessary. Next point is: the Indian desert region is known as the Thar desert region. The Peninsular Plateau is a tableland which is divided into 2 regions, the Central Highland and the Deccan Plateau. The western coastal plains is made up of the Konkan coast, Kannara plains and the Malabar coast. The eastern coastal plains is made up of the Northern Circus and the Coromandel coast. And India has 2 groups of islands, the Lakshadweep Islands in the Arabian Sea and the Andaman Nicobar Islands in the Bay of Bengal. So, whenever you find the Lakshadweep and the Andaman and Nicobar Islands on the map, the picture will be clear to you and it is easy, it will be easy for you to memorize. Okay. So, today I'll tell you the question answers, objective type question answer. Firstly, answer in 1 or 2 words. India is officially known as this. Answer: Republic of India. Next, part of India which includes the states of Bihar, Jharkhand, Orisha, West Bengal and Union Territory of Andaman and Nicobar Islands. Answer, Eastern India. Next, Central Zone of India refers to these two states. Answer, Madhya Pradesh and Chhattisgarh. Next, Himalayas are also known as this. Answer, Young Fold Mountains. Next is the highest mountain range of the Himalayas. You all know that. The Greater Himalayas or Himadri, which is in the northernmost part. You can see it, you can find it on map and so that you can remember it easily. The outermost range of the Himalayas, Shivaliks. Outermost range, that means the southernmost range of the Himalayas, that is Shivaliks. Next is world's highest peak. Answer, Mount Everest. Next, all great valleys are present here. Answer, the Lesser Himalayas or Himachal. There are many great valleys, Kashmir valleys, Kangra valleys, etc. Next is the valleys lying between the Himachal and the Shivaliks are called this. This Dun. So the valleys between Himachal and Shivaliks are called as Dun. Next, the Indian desert region is known as this. Answer is third desert region. Indian desert region is known as third desert region, which lies in the western side of India. Whenever you find it on the map, then it will be clear to you where is third desert. Okay, so always consult the map. Next, highest peak of Eastern Ghats. Answer, Mahendragiri. The type of soil deposited by the flowing rivers in the northern plains. The type of soil deposited by the flowing rivers in the northern plains. That is alluvial soil. Always focus on the pronunciation too. It is also very much important. Whenever you pronounce it correctly, then the spelling will be correct. Okay. Next, the administrative headquarters of Lakshadweep. Answer, Kavaratti. Next, the southern part of eastern coastal plain. Answer, Coromandel Coast. Next, largest saltwater lake in India. This is very important. Largest saltwater lake in India, Chilka Lake. It is in Odisha. Next type of question is, fill in the blanks. India is the 7th largest country in dash. Answer, Asia. The Tropic of Dash almost divides the country into two parts. Northern India and the Deccan and Peninsular India. Two blanks are there. Here, the Tropic of Cancer almost divides the country into two parts. Northern India and the Deccan and Peninsular India. Okay. Next is, India is the dash populated country in the world. Second most populated country in the world. Next, the landmass of India has an area of about 3.28 million square kilometers. Here was the blank, 3.28. Next, from north to south, India is about 3,200 kilometers stretching from the dash to dash. Himalayas to Kanyakumari, from north in northern part, from Himalayas to Kanyakumari is the southern tip of India. Next, India is broadly divided into 6 natural regions. Next, dash means the abode or house of snow in Sanskrit. It is Himalaya. Himalaya means the abode or house of snow in Sanskrit. Next is, between the Himachal and the Shivaliks, the valley of Dash is the biggest, Dehradun. Dehradun valley is the biggest between the Himachal and Shivaliks. There are many valleys between Himachal and Shivaliks, you know, as I told you before. And the valleys are called as what? Yes, those are called as Dun. And among them, Dehradun is the biggest. Okay. Next, the Himalayas run in a westest direction from the Dash to the Brahmaputra River. Indus to the Brahmaputra River. Next, the only large river in third desert is Luni. Luni is the only large river. Peninsular plateau is a table land which contains igneous rocks. Next, the central highlands lies to the north of the Narmada River. Narmada River, the central highland lies to the north of the Narmada River. The eastern ghats stretch from Mahanadi Valley to the Nilgiris in the south. Mahanadi to Nilgiris. Okay. And the highest peak of the western ghats is Anaimudi. The Kannara Plains makes the central part of western coast. The Kannara Plain makes the central part of western coast. Next, the delta formed by the Ganga and Brahmaputra before draining into the Bay of Bengal is Sundarban Delta. Next, the Deccan Plateau is surrounded by narrow coastal plains on the east and west. There are narrow coastal plains which surrounds the Deccan Plateau. It is a triangular shaped plateau, you know. Next, the Satpura Range makes the northern part of the central highland. Right? Next type of question is write T for true and F for false statement, and also correct the false statement. Number one, the Indian landmass has a central location between East and West Africa. Answer is false. So the correct, what was the correct statement? Correct statement is the Indian landmass has a central location between East and West Asia. Next. The standard meridian of India passes through Mirzapur in Uttar Pradesh. It is true. Next, Andaman and Nicobar Islands are made up of 233 small islands. True. Next, the northern part of the eastern coastal plains is called Konkan. It is false. The correct statement is, the northern part of the eastern coastal plain is called Northern Circuits. You can find it in map. Next, the capital of Andaman and Nicobar Islands is Port Blair. It is also a true statement. Next, the Ganga Plain forms the eastern part of the northern plains. The Ganga Plains forms the eastern part of the northern plains. It is also false. Correct statement, the Brahmaputra Plain forms the eastern part of the northern plains. Next, the Great Himalayas consist of 3 parallel ranges. It is true, you know. Next, number 8, Thar Desert lies towards the eastern margins of the Aravalli Hills. It is false. So, the correct statement is third desert lies towards the western margins of the Aravalli Hills. So that it is a desert land. Give examples for each of the following. Firstly, peaks of Himadri, Mount Everest. Himadri is the greater Himalayas. Mount Everest, Kanchenjunga, Annapurna, Dholgiri, Nanga Parbat. Okay. Next, valleys of Himachal, Kashmir Valley, Kangra Valley, Kulu Valley. Next, hill stations of Himachal. You can memorize two is enough. You can memorize three. Kullu, Manali, Kufri, Shimla, Mussoorie, Nainital, etc. Next, tributaries of Indus. Jhelum, Chenab, Ravi, Bias and Satluj. Next is tributaries of Ganga, Yamuna, Ghaghra, Gandak, Koshi, Tista, etc. So, this was the objective type questions. There is many questions in this chapter. And here in the above question answer, objective type question answers, the question answer, objective type question answers from the questions from the book is also included. So, you all write it in your copy. In your class copy and memorize them with the help of map. Okay, so this much for today's class, and bye till our next class.